trouble for Gen Z in the workplace. Employers are reporting that this generation is the most difficult to work with.
So Generation Z is all grown up and ready to take over the workforce, right? Well, hold up. Hiring managers aren't exactly rolling out the welcome mat for them. In fact, it's more like a door in the face. You'd think they were expecting zombies, not 20-somethings eager to prove their worth. But no, 40% of hiring managers are side-eyeing those Gen Z resumes, like they've been printed on toxic waste. According to ResumeBuilder.com, age bias is alive and well, and the kids aren't all right, at least not in the eyes of their potential employers. Out of 1,000 hiring managers surveyed, 42% admitted, yes, admitted, that they do, in fact, take age into account when reviewing job applications. No big surprise there, but here's the kicker. Being young can hurt just as much as being too experienced. Yep, whether you're fresh out of college or nearing retirement, your resume might be heading straight for the shredder. Oh, and for the seniors reading this, don't get too comfortable. Turns out 33% of hiring managers feel the same about your applications. It's not just the Gen Zers they've got a problem with. Ageism? More like age everyone? What's the deal with Gen Z? You'd think companies would be thrilled to hire a generation that grew up with the internet in their cribs. But nope. Apparently knowing how to use TikTok and fix Wi-Fi issues isn't enough to get you a job. Instead, Gen Z's lack of experience is a huge red flag for almost 80% of hiring managers. Wait, you mean to tell me the generation that's barely had time to gather years of experience doesn't have enough years of experience? Shocker. Let's add more fuel to this fire, shall we? Around 58% of hiring managers worry that Gen Z has an unprofessional attitude. Yeah, because responding to emails with K or LOL really hurts their feelings, I guess. And don't even start on the job hopping accusations. 63% think Gen Z is more likely to leave their job faster than you can say work-life balance. Heaven forbid they explore their options or search for something they actually enjoy. Oh, and it gets better. 1 in 2 hiring managers don't even believe Gen Z can show up to work on time. Reliability and work ethic? Nope, not in this generation. At least not according to the dinosaurs making these hiring decisions. But wait, here's the cherry on top. 46% of those same managers actually think their company is better off avoiding Gen Z altogether. Yes, you heard right. Better to just keep pretending like the largest, tech-savviest generation doesn't exist. Good luck with that strategy, folks. Pandemic pandemonium. Let's give Gen Z a little break, shall we? After all, they entered the workforce during a pandemic. Imagine trying to learn the ropes of office politics over Zoom, while also wondering if wearing pajama pants to a virtual meeting is a fireable offense. It's not their fault they didn't get the same hands-on training as previous generations. According to Stacy Haller, chief career advisor at Resume Builder, a lot of companies were totally unprepared to train this generation. So instead of teaching them the ropes, they just blame them for not knowing the ropes. Makes sense, right? HR versus reality. Who's right? Not everyone's on board with the anti-Gen Z sentiment. Consultant Brian Driscoll thinks the whole Gen Z is bad for business narrative is as outdated as a fax machine. He argues that Gen Z's tech savviness, passion for social and environmental causes, and desire for meaningful work could actually make them a huge asset to any company that pulls its head out of the sand long enough to realize it. But of course, that would mean rethinking all those stereotypes, which is apparently a Herculean task for some hiring managers. Gen Z wants fair compensation in a workplace that doesn't treat them like expendable cogs in a machine, Driscoll says, but apparently that's asking too much. These hiring managers just see entitlement, not the legitimate push for better working conditions. Because, you know, heaven forbid someone expects to be treated fairly in a job, Let's talk consequences, because, oh, there will be consequences. If companies keep acting like hiring Gen Z is the equivalent of inviting chaos into their office, they're in for a rude awakening. By refusing to hire young talent, these businesses are going to find themselves left in the dust, wondering why they can't attract anyone under the age of 30. Guess what, hiring managers? That fresh perspective, digital fluency, and desire for positive change you're so scared of? Yeah, those are the things that could keep your company afloat in a rapidly changing world. And let's not forget that by 2025, Gen Z will make up 30% of the global workforce. If you're still clinging to your anti-Gen Z biases by then, good luck finding anyone to fill those empty desks. And no, the boomers can't work forever. Hate to break it to you. Like and subscribe.